Definition is a rectangular array of real numbers arranged in rows and columns. Now, it is very important that you know how to read the order of a given matrix, because this will help us in evaluating and simplifying some of the matrices that we will have in the future. Now, order of a matrix means an arrangement of matrix by m rows and n columns. Now, m here is represented by the number of rows in a given matrix, and letter n is the number of columns in a matrix. Now, the standard form of an m by n matrix, which means we have an m number of rows and n number of columns, is given by this format. So this is the standard form, and if you will notice, we'll have some subscripts in each of the entry that we have in this matrix. So we have a sub 1, 1, a sub 2, 1, up until a sub m 1. Now, the subscript that you are seeing right now is basically a placeholder for each entry in our m by n matrix. And to make sense of this standard form, let's have the example right here of an m by n matrix given by a equal to these entries of our matrix. Now, the first thing that you need to understand to be able to work with a matrix is to know the order of a matrix. And for matrix A, the order of this matrix is 1, 2, 3 number of rows and 1, 2, 3, 4 number of columns. So this matrix A is a 3 by 4 matrix. Now, you have to understand that a 3 by 4 matrix is not the same as a 4 by 3 matrix. The number right here, which is 3, is the number of rows, and 4 is the number of columns. So the row always comes first before the number of columns, and that is the order of a given matrix. Now, if we're going to find the entry or specific entry in this 3 by 4 matrix, for example, if we're going to locate matrix or the entry A11, entry A11 in this particular matrix means row 1, column 1, which gives us 3. So A11 is equal to 3. So the subscript here is our way of locating the entry or specific entry in a given m by n matrix. So if we need to find A sub 3, 2, or the entry in that matrix, which is located at A sub 3, 2. So we have 3 columns, or third column, and second row, 1, 2. So A sub 3, 2 is equal to 5. And A sub 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1 is 4. And if we need to find A sub 4, 1, which means fourth row, 1, 2, 3, obviously, fourth row is not here in our m by n matrix. Therefore, this particular entry of a matrix is null, so which means it's empty because it's not in our m by n matrix. And this is how we understand the order of a matrix and how we locate a specific entry in a given m by n matrix. Now, another major or important terminology that we need to understand about matrices is the square matrix. Now, a square matrix in linear algebra means a matrix with equal number of rows and equal number of columns. So I have your three examples of a square matrix. So we have square matrix or a 2x2 matrix, which is a square matrix because we have 1, 2 rows, 1, 2 columns. And we have a 3x3 and a 4x4. All of them are called square matrices because they have the same number of rows and same number of columns. Another term that we need to learn in linear algebra is the main diagonal. Now, the terms that I am introducing in this particular lesson are the terms that we are going to use in studying further the ways or methods on how to apply the concept of a matrix in linear algebra. Now, the main diagonal, by definition, is basically the elements from the upper left to the lower right of a square matrix. Now, for example number one, I have here a square matrix which is similar to this particular example. The diagonal, or the main diagonal of this matrix, will be 3 and 5, which means the entry from the upper left down to the lower right. And the second matrix that I have, which is similar to this matrix, a 3x3 matrix, my main diagonal will be 1, 8, 3, because according to the definition, they are the entries from the upper left going to the lower right. And for our third example, this is a 1, 2, 3 by 1, 2, 3, 4 matrix. So that means this is not a square matrix. And if it's not a square matrix, the main diagonal is also null. So the main diagonal for the third matrix will not exist because it's not a square matrix. And those are the two important terminologies or words that we are going to use in our lesson in the future. Now, one of the major applications of matrix in linear algebra is converting a linear system into a matrix, because we can do or we can have a lot of operations in solving the solutions of linear systems using a matrix. Now, for example, I have here a linear system, which is 2x plus 3y equal to 7, and x plus y is equal to negative 2. The first conversion that I'm going to do is to convert a linear system into an augmented matrix. Now, an augmented matrix is basically dropping the variables in your coefficients and just copying all the numerical value or coefficient in your linear system. So for the first row, I have my first linear system. So I have 2, 3, and 7. So now my augmented matrix for my first row is 2, 3, equal to 7. So this is my x column, y column, and this is the right-hand side. And for my second row, I have x plus y equal to negative 2. So I have 1, 1, and negative 2. So this is now my augmented matrix, which I converted from the linear system that we have in example number 1. Now, another conversion that we can do in a linear system going to a matrix is what we call as the coefficient matrix. Now, the coefficient matrix is basically the coefficient of your augmented matrix dropping your right-hand side. So for this particular linear system, the coefficient matrix is just 2, 3, 1, 1. So this is the coefficient matrix. So we have two conversions for this particular linear system. We have the augmented matrix and a coefficient matrix. And for our second example, this is different for example number 1 because example number 1, we only have x and y for our variable. Now for second example, we have x, y, z for our linear system. So therefore, since we have a three-dimensional system of equation right here, we'll have a different size or order of a given matrix. So to convert this linear system to an augmented matrix, for our first row, we have x, y, negative 3z equal to 5. So that will be easy because all we need to do is to drop the variable and copy the coefficient. So we'll have 1, 1, negative 3 equal to 5. Now for the second row, we have a missing variable. So notice that we don't have the y variable. Now it is very important that you know the placeholder of each variable, because if you mistook this particular linear equation as 0, 2, 1, 1, then your matrix will no longer be valid. So make sure that you know what is the missing variable in your given linear system. So for equation number 2, or linear equation number 2, we are missing a y. So to change this into an augmented matrix, we'll have 2, 0, 1, and 1. And for our third linear equation, 3y minus x is equal to negative 2, we are missing the variable z, and also x is located on a different position compared to the first two equations that we have. So you also need to take notice of that. So to convert 3y minus x equal to negative 2 into our third row in our augmented matrix, it's going to be negative 1, positive 3, 0, equal to negative 2. So this is our augmented matrix, and to change it, our augmented matrix into the coefficient matrix, just drop your right hand side and you'll have 1, 1, negative 3, 2, 0, 1, negative 1, 3, 0, which is basically a square matrix for example number 1 and example number 2. And that is how we apply the linear equation and converting it into a matrix.